Welcome back to the Washington State Dynasty, and welcome to Aloha Stadium, a big-time rematch in the Pac-12 championship game here today. Number 2 versus number 7 with a national championship berth on the line. And our first matchup of the year came down to the last quarter. Robert Lundy scores the touchdown to give us the lead. And then from there, all we had to do was run out the clock. A perfect throw to Marcus Stanford, a big-time senior performer. And we would end up clinching that game and have not lost all this year. So Southern Cal will look for revenge while we look to get into the national championship here today. Here's Tony Gaines. He makes a move and picks up a first down on our first offensive play. Second down and 7. Will spread the field with 4 wide. It's Kerry Webb on the catch, and he's brought down by his face mask, so tack on an additional 15 yards and an automatic first down. Sticking with the 4 wide set, Tony Gaines to the outside. It's caught by Richie Wiley. The corner missed it, and Wiley will go for 21 yards. Sticking with the 2x2 look, Gaines is hit, tries to escape, and goes down for a loss of 10. Now third down and 17 will go to the ground, and Corey Washington maybe got a yard. So now Victor McGill, the senior kicker, is on. His kick is away, and it is good. So we have an early 3-0 lead. A look at the SEC championship as number 3 Florida beats LSU. So that could be a possible matchup for us in the national championship game if we do win. Now it's Darryl Lewis, and he's got 20 yards. Isaac Gray, their star senior quarterback, will not be playing today, so will be Lewis playing in his stead. Tyrone Walker on the slant for 13 yards. Lewis will drop back once again. He dumps it down to Roberson, his running back, and he is brought down after around an 8-yard gain. Now they'll go with a read option. It's Lewis up the middle. He has some room to run. He's inside of the 15-yard line, a 13-yard gain. From the pistol, here's Roberson. He finds a big hole and runs in for 13 yards and gives Southern Cal the early lead. Now it's Corey Washington on the give, and he's brought down after a 3-yard gain. Avery Burgess was shaken up on that first down play, so we'll have to keep an eye on that. Corey Washington will replace in the meantime, as they do get the stop, so Southern Cal will take back over, going play action from a full house set. Lewis tries to run, and he'll lose 4 yards. He's sacked by Alex Gibson, another big-time senior performer. Third down and 13 along the sideline. Marcel Stewart, our number one corner, gets beat for 50 yards. First down and goal. Throw to the end zone, and it's a touchdown for Benson Johnson. Our defense has not looked very good so far, putting up 0 fight. Our offense is going to need to answer if we want to stay in this game. Can't let it get out of hand too early. Tony Gaines breaking tackles, another one, and finally brought down after a 33-yard gain. A huge play. We'll go play action, and this time the offensive line can't protect Gaines. He'll lose 6. It's now second down and long as we'll go to the air, and Robert Lundy makes the one-handed catch, and it's now third down and much more manageable. On third down, the throw goes to Kerry Webb, and he can't make the catch. A big drop, and we'll be forced to punt the ball away. So first down and 10, a quick throw off of play action as Marcus Smith picks up a first down. It's second down and inches. Here's Roberson, and he picks up another first down on a gain of 3. We near the end of the first quarter. Southern Cal will keep with up tempo. Another quick throw out of play action, and it works once again. 18 yards. Pressure almost got there. Instead, it goes for a big gain. On third down, it's not a stop. Darryl King was in the backfield and just barely getting the first down is Roberson. Now he goes down to the backfield. This time, a loss of 5. Jesse Shaw making the play. We'll bring another blitz. It's Lewis to the outside and another open man. It's Vincent Johnson once more. On third down and 4, play action. And Lewis will throw it away. Flag down though. Might be intentional grounding. No, they call pass interference on Washington State and on Patrick Cole, the redshirt freshman, with a big mistake, and that will continue the drive. And the ball comes out. It's Joey Clark who scoops it up. A huge play. Patrick Cole makes up for it by forcing the fumble. Now Corey Washington gets the handoff, and he loses a yard. So third down and 8. The throw, it's a lob, and it's picked off by Jackson. A huge turnover, way too much air under that. And it was also intended for Melvin Hall. Just an awful throw overall. Roberson gets the carry after a missed play by Brian Wiley. Now a throw across the middle to Johnson, and he's got it to the 5-yard line. It's goal to go. They'll go 4 wide, draw play to Roberson, and he gets into the end zone. A great play call, and they now have a 3-score lead. 21-3, we're going to need to answer quickly. The throw, it's nearly intercepted again by Jackson. We get lucky, and now it's 3rd down and 10. Avery Burgess still isn't in the game as Kerry Webb catches it for 20 yards. Same formation, 1st down and 10, lobbing it down the field, and it's intercepted. Jones this time has it, put it up for Kerry Webb, and he could not get it. So now 2nd down and 2, the give goes to Lewis as he will keep it and go for 11 yards. Southern Cal has a chance to extend their lead, but it's Luke Harris in the backfield coming in unblocked, a loss of 5. 4 wide set on 3rd down and 14, and that's nearly intercepted by Marcel Stewart, could not come away with it. So we will take over with 2.5 minutes left in this first half. Here's Corey Washington, who goes for 7 yards. We need points on this drive. So now a throw to the outside. It's Kerry Webb. He catches it, almost intercepted once again. Luckily, it wasn't. 1st down and 10, running the read option. Here's Tony Gaines up the middle. He'll slide and avoid any big hits, just short of the 1st down line. 2nd down and inches. Here's Kerry Webb. Tries to make a move, but he's got 21 yards and a big-time play. Southern Cal does get the ball to start the second half, so that just adds even more importance to getting points in this drive. Terry Davis checks in the game. He'll get the carry, and he picks up the 1st down, a 4-yard gain. On 2nd down, Corey Washington will check back in. He runs through a defender and gets into the end zone, a huge touchdown. Avery Burgess still not back in the game. Corey Washington playing very well, though. Now the throw, and that's nearly intercepted by David Downs. It could have been another opportunity for points. Instead, 2nd down and 10, and a hard hit by Jimmy Benson. And we will head into halftime down by 11. A big drive to end the half. Could have had that interception. A look at the stats for the first half. 2 turnovers are the big story so far for Washington State. Haven't really got much going so far in offense while not being able to stop Southern Cal other than the 1 interception. Now it's Colbert. He's got it for 5 yards, so 3rd down and short, a twin tight end look. And the linebacker Raymond Barber takes a bad angle, and it allows Roberson to pick up 12 yards and a first. From the pistol, Lewis on a quick throw once more. He's done a great job of getting the ball out of his hands and not really feeling much pressure because he's doing such a good job of it. Now a fake jet sweep, it's Lewis who will lose a couple. Sydney Phillips makes the play. 3rd down and 14. Lewis to the outside, and Stewart drops another one. The team leader in interceptions cannot make the play so far today. Melvin Hall gets the catch on a short throw for around 5 yards. As Avery Burgess has returned, he's going to try and give it a go. Now the ball is out, it's still loose, and Southern Cal recovers it. Another big turnover. Our offense just seemed to not be able to get out of their own way today. Now it's Lewis, he breaks one tackle and has a 1st down, a 12-yard gain. Forcing a field goal here would be huge, but Lewis goes for 9 and picks up the 1st down. 1st down and goal, we bring the blitz, and it's Lewis who's brought down, a loss of 4. The corner makes a huge play, 3rd down and goal, and Lewis will take off, no one's home, and he scores. And it's now a 3-score lead once again. It's very dire. We've got to work quickly. Kerry Webb goes for 12 yards. We'll stick with a 4-wide set with trips to the right. Tony Gaines is going to go deep. He's got a man out there. It's Lundy who comes down with it. He finally goes up and makes a big play. 1st down and 10. Throw to the end zone. And Wiley has it. A 14-yard touchdown. And that's the quick answer we needed, a 16-second drive. Only problem with that is our defense goes right back onto the field, not a lot of time to catch their breath. Colbert goes for 12 yards on the reception. Under 3 minutes left in the third quarter, here's Walker once more. He has killed us all day along with Vincent Johnson. They're both very talented receivers who have a future in the NFL. Now it's Clayton across the middle. He's got to the 30-yard line, a gain of 18. They bring a man in motion. Lewis moves in the pocket, finds his receiver Whaley, and he's got 4 yards. So it's third down, forcing a field goal and a stop here would be huge. And it's a big time play. That's David Downs. He is a sophomore corner making a big play. So now the field goal is good, but we keep it as a 2-score lead. Gaines hands the ball off to Burgess. He's definitely not 100%, but he's giving it his best go. Third down and 2, it's a quarterback keeper, and Gaines breaks through and gets 7 yards and a big first down. We'll spread it out with a 4-wide look. A throw will go to Burgess. He's got some room to run, makes a cut, and is down after a face mask, so that'll tack on some extra yardage. On first down and 10, Gaines runs, pitches it to Burgess. He's inside of the 10 and brought down. It's first down and goal. A split back set. Throw goes and Washington can't make the catch. He drops it. So third down and goal now. Gaines from the pocket, throws quick. It's Wiley once again. And he's into the end zone for the second time today, as that is now the second passing touchdown for Tony Gaines on the day. You can see 2 touchdowns in the second half compared to 2 interceptions. He's really stepped up his play. Second down and 9, a sweep outside goes to Roberson. He's got 6 yards. We're into the fourth quarter. It's third down and 3. Here's Thorne, the backup running back, gets the first down, a 9-yard run, and that will move the sticks. So play action, throw to the outside along the sideline. It's Tyrone Walker. He makes the toe tapping catch. Play action once again, and another throw, this time to Jamal Britt, and it goes for 10 yards. Second down and 3. Here's Lewis on the carry. He has room. He tries to cut it back inside. Probably should have stayed outside, but it's first down and goal nonetheless. Throw to the corner of the end zone, and nearly intercepted once again. Still do not have a pick on the day, as now it goes, and it's a touchdown for Darryl Lewis. The flag is offsides on linebacker Eric Sykes, so the touchdown will stand. Richie Wiley on the catch, he goes for 18 yards. Nice run after the catch. First down and 10. Throw goes to Wiley. He's got 14 yards. We're inside of Southern Cal territory. On first down and 10. Lob down the sideline, and it's Wiley once again. 36 yards as our receivers are finally starting to make the plays, and Burgess will punch it in, and it's a 1-score game. Second down and 8. Here's Lewis, and the ball's out, but it's recovered by Kyle Lucas. A big time play, and we can't capitalize on the opportunity. Throw goes to Britt, and it's a big stop, ending forcing of a punt. Our defense couldn't recover the fumble, but our offense will take over, and it's Kerry Webb. He gets us into Southern Cal territory. Two receivers flank the offensive line as the dump down goes to Avery Burgess for 9 yards. Sticking with this same formation, something new that we brought into this game to hopefully exploit the defense, but it's intercepted by Jackson for Washington State's 4th turnover on the day. Lewis will try and take off, and he's brought down hard by Jesse Shaw. Second down and 14, a 3-wide set as Lewis will take off. He has room to run, and he's brought down after an 8-yard gain. We have a chance for a stop as Lewis breaks one tackle, and the defense swarms to him. He's sacked. It's Eric Sykes, the speedy linebacker. The punt just barely gets away. Xavier Clark back to return it. The true freshman has it. He tries to break it to the outside. He has some room to run, makes a cut. He breaks free. He's gonna take it all the way and tie up this game at 38, pinning the field goal, a 61-yard return. What a play. First down and 10, 2 minutes left. Lewis will lose 3 yards. Now second down and 13. throw to the outside for Britt, and he's brought down a gain of 7, and it's third down once again. We'll bring a blitz with 5 linebackers on the field, and they use their speed to chase down Daryl Lewis and stop the run. So a minute and a half left in this game, it's Avery Burgess who goes for 9 yards. All we need is a field goal. Field goal range is probably about the 35-yard line as Burgess fights forward and he gets us into field goal range. Right on the edge, more yardage would make it much more manageable as Tony Gaines has it. It's now 2nd down and 4. Inside of the 10-yard line, it's Burgess. 1st down and goal. Victor McGill will come on. He's iced. So with a spot in the national championship on the line, it's Victor McGill, the senior kicker. His kick is right down the middle, and we will do it. 1 second left. Here's the kick from McGill. He'll just squib it. It's recovered by the tight end, Colbert. And McGill makes the tackle. He makes the game-winning kick and the tackle on the final play. And we are Pac-12 champions. And that should secure us a place in the national championship. Avery Burgess comes back, plays a huge role in the comeback. Tony Gaines steps it up big in the second half. And of course, senior receiver Richie Wiley has a great day today. He is one of the best players that we've seen in this series. He always makes huge plays. He has always been a deep threat, but through his career, he's definitely become much more sure-handed. Kerry Webb also played a big role, 90 yards. Luke Harris with 4 tackles for losses. Eric Sykes has a sack, and we don't end up with an interception, 2 drop picks, and somehow we were able to win this game with 4 turnovers. Not our best game, only forced 1. You can see player of the game, it's Richie Wiley and Luke Harris. Wiley was the Pac-12 championship player of the game, and our hopes have been realized. The national championship will feature Washington State against Notre Dame. We had to beat one of the premier programs in all of college football to get here in Southern Cal, and we'll have to do it once more if we want to win this national championship. Notre Dame is led by a very talented senior quarterback and Marcus Foster. Only 3 interceptions on the season. Reminds me a lot of Marcus Mariota. He's very proficient, very efficient, and just a great player. You can see the Heisman does go to David Lynch in a little bit of a runaway. Tony Gaines finishes 4th. But that's hard to take away from Lynch. He had an incredible season. Like I said, Maurice Foster doesn't have the size of Mariota, but definitely takes care of the ball and can run the ball like Mariota could in college. Now, Andrew Harris, the star receiver, he gets a lot of the passing targets on this team. No real great pass rusher or turnover, interception type guy on this defense for Notre Dame. You can see some of the awards. O'Brien goes to Maurice Foster, with Tony Gaines finishing in 2nd place. And for this game, we'll be getting back All-American linebacker Alex Dixon, 51 tackles on the season. You can see Maurice Foster, he's a great athlete, 91 speed, and has a pretty good arm, very accurate. At running back, you have Chance Pruitt. He has the ability to run through and also make you miss with some nice speed. At receiver, a lot of very good targets, a lot of youth in the receiving corps as well, with a couple of sophomores. On the defensive side, you have Curtis Woodward, the star player out of Oregon. So he came from our neck of the woods in the Northeast. He has the speed and ball skills and can also lay the wood. But I hope you did enjoy today's video. If you did, please leave a like down below. Leave your comments on the game down below. What are your expectations for this national championship game? What are your keys to the game for the national championship game against Notre Dame? But like I said, I hope you did enjoy. I will see you in Pasadena for the Fiesta Bowl and National Championship game, 'cause I'm out.